God being Jesus and the Father and the Holy Spirit, yet all one being, doesn't seem to make sense.
In Exodus chapter 6, he says, up until this moment, you have not really understood. I revealed myself to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob as God Almighty, El Shaddai. But now I am revealing myself to you as your covenant-keeping God, a God who is what you need Him to be in your life situation.
How apostate can the mainstream religion of Christianity become? They recreate God. He is now customized to be the God you need Him to be in your particular situation.
A God who is what you need Him to be in your life situation. Jesus Christ comes to earth. But He wasn't just Jesus Christ. He was the Lord Jesus Christ.
Here we have a perfect example of the deceptive tactics of the Trinitarian and those who teach that Christ is God clothed in flesh. They always make an issue of Christ's title, which is Lord. That Christ is King of Kings and that He is Lord of Lords is never in dispute. Yet the fact that Christ is Lord does not make Him God. The deceivers attempt to use the title Lord as it is ascribed to Christ and make it a name that is synonymous of God's name. Those who do this are deliberately attempting to deceive. They prey on the minds of the ignorant who, when they hear Lord, think it is the name of God. The phrase Lord of Lords itself demonstrates that the word Lord is not another name for God Almighty. If it were, then the phrase would have the following meaning. He is Lord, God Almighty, of all other lords, all other almighty gods. If the word Lord, as used when speaking of Christ, means God Almighty or Yahweh God, then the phrase He is Lord of Lords acknowledges that there are more than one Yahweh God over which the Lord Jesus is God. So, in an incredibly ironic twist, those who say Jesus is Lord and use that as some proof that He is God Almighty are revealing their truly polytheistic mindset. For Jesus is Lord of Lords, and they obviously believe that Lord means God Almighty. Therefore, there are other gods, other lords, over whom Jesus is Lord. They prey on those who are too ignorant to understand that Jesus is our Lord, He is our King, but He is not God Almighty.
And in John chapter 8, when they were asking Him where He had come from, He said this, before Abraham, I am.
The teacher in this video completely misrepresented John chapter 8. When Christ made His famous declaration, before Abraham was, I am, no one was asking Him where He came from.
When they were asking Him where He had come from.
Alert! This is a complete lie. We will look at the verses in a moment and you will see that the Trinitarians misrepresent what the Bible says at every turn to try and defend their Trinity deceptions. In John chapter 8, Christ had promised eternal life to all who would keep His words, and this angered the Jews because Abraham and all the other prophets were dead, and it seemed to them that Christ was therefore claiming to be greater than Abraham and all the prophets.
Verily, verily, I say unto you, if a man keep my saying, he shall never see death. Then said the Jews unto him, now we know that thou hast a devil. Abraham is dead, and the prophets. And thou sayest, if a man keepeth my saying, he shall never taste of death. Art thou greater than our father Abraham, which is dead, and the prophets are dead? Whom makest thou thyself?
The question the Jews asked Christ was not, where do you come from? It was, whom do you make yourself? And Christ denied making Himself anyone or anything, which He could not have truthfully done if He was in fact the Creator God and He had made Himself the Son of God.
When they were asking Him where He had come from.
Whom makest thou thyself?
Where He had come from.
Whom makest thou thyself?
When they were asking Him where He had come from.
This teacher has lost all credibility already. He doesn't even appear to know what John 8 was about. He thinks that the Jews were asking Jesus where he came from. You have to wonder if he even read John 8 before preaching on it. But this teacher is not in error. He's deliberately deceiving and misquoting scripture. Notice how he chops off the majority of Christ's response to the question posed by the Jews.
He said this, "Before Abraham, I am."
As we're going to see by reading the text ourselves, Christ had far more to say to them than, "Before Abraham was, I am."
Jesus answered, "If I honor myself, my honor is nothing. It is my Father that honoreth me, of whom ye say that he is your God. Yet ye have not known him, but I know him. And if I should say, I know him not, I shall be a liar like unto you. But I know him, and keep his saying. Your father Abraham rejoiced to see my day, and he saw it, and was glad."
There we have Christ's main response to the question, "Whom do you make yourself?" Christ states that he does not honor himself. If he is actually God, clothed in flesh, then indeed he was a liar, and he was honoring himself, being God himself, and giving honor to his fleshly self, which he made himself. This is the truth that Trinitarians everywhere conveniently ignore. If Christ was God himself come down to earth in fleshly form, then when Christ spoke of God as him and as someone else that he knows, Christ was simply lying. Christ told the Jews in John 8 that he did not honor himself, yet God honored Christ all the time. Either Christ is not God, or Christ was lying in John 8 when he said he does not honor himself. And Christ told the Jews that he knows the one they call their God, John 8, 54 through 55. Now, if Christ is their God, then he's being deceptive by saying he knows their God and keeps his words. Either Christ is not the God of the Jews, for he says that he only knows him, or Christ is the God of the Jews come in fleshly form, and he's simply lying and being deceptive. Or Christ did not know he was in fact the God of the Jews come to earth. Which of course begs the question, how does an all-knowing God not know who he is?
"Your father Abraham rejoiced to see my day, and he saw it, and was glad. Then said the Jews unto him, Thou art not yet 50 years old, and hast thou seen Abraham?"
Here the Jews seek to twist Christ's words. Christ had just said that Abraham saw his day and rejoiced. Christ did not say that he saw Abraham. He simply says Abraham saw his day. Yet the Jews twisted his words to say that he had somehow known Abraham personally. The apostles explained how Abraham had seen Christ's day from afar off.
"These all died in faith, not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off, and were persuaded of them, and embraced them, and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth."
Indeed, Abraham had seen Christ's day. He died awaiting the promise, for Christ was the promised seed of Abraham.
"Now to Abraham and his seed were the promises made. He saith not, and to seeds as of many, but as of one, and to thy seed, which is Christ."
So Christ stated rightly that Abraham had seen his day and rejoiced. Yet the Jews did not understand him, were unaware that the promised seed was Christ, and that Jesus was the Christ. Then Christ made his famous declaration to the Jews.
"Jesus said unto them, Verily, verily, I say unto you, before Abraham was, I am."
Trinitarians make extreme issue out of the phrase, "I am," which is the actual transliteration of YHWH or Yahweh. Yet, Jesus did not say, "Before Abraham was, I am that I am," which is precisely what he would have had to say in order to be calling himself Yahweh. Yet, this is precisely what the Trinity deceivers claim Christ said.
He was declaring to them that he was Jehovah God.
This again is a complete and utter lie. They ignore how Christ had just said that he does not honor himself, that his Father honors him, and that Christ states that he knows the one whom the Jews call God, not that he is the one that the Jews call God. Christ's response to the Jews in John 8 shows the opposite of what Trinitarians claim. Christ makes it clear that he is not the God of the Jews, but that he knows the God of the Jews. If he is actually declaring himself to be the God of the Jews, then his earlier statements that he does not honor himself and that he knows the God of the Jews were self-contradictory and were all-out lies. Yet, even if Jesus' words were declaring, "I am the great I am," Trinitarians forget that Christ's words were not his own. He only spoke what came directly from the Father.
"Believest thou not that I am in the Father, and the Father in me? The words that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works."
When Christ spoke, he did not speak of himself. He spoke directly from the Father. Therefore, when he said, "Before Abraham was, I am," he was not speaking of himself. He was speaking of the Father. The Jews did not understand this, and neither apparently do the Trinitarians and those who say that Christ is God clothed in flesh. In the most amazing irony of all, the Trinitarians actually use the error of the Jews to support their Trinity doctrine. They actually use the reaction of the Jews to this statement of Christ as some sort of evidence that they are right. They actually side with the Jews on this issue, the Jews who sought to stone Christ. They misunderstand Christ just like the godless Jews did and say no wonder they tried to stone him.
No wonder they took up stones to kill him, because he was proclaiming that he was the covenant-keeping God of his people. And tonight,
these Trinitarians actually empathize with those who tried to stone and ultimately killed Jesus Christ. They use the reaction of a group of men that were so devoid of God's Spirit that they sought to stone the Christ. These are the men they turn to for testimony as to what Christ meant when he said, "Before Abraham was, I am."